Okay, welcome back, guys. So let's start working on the face. So I'm going to start by creating a new layer for the face. So let us go to the highest subdivision level for this first. So let's go to the highest subdivision level. Then under layers, I would like to. Oh, before I do that, I think we need some details for the neck. Let me just use the clay build-up brush. Let's go one subdivision level higher. Yeah, just smooth that down a bit more on the side. Yeah, something like this should be fine, I guess. Okay. So back to the higher subdivision level. I'm supposed to even rename these to primary forms. Let me add torso at the end. Just to be more precise. And I'll create a new layer. Primary edge form. So this particular one will just be for the head only. So before I continue, I like to bring the image of the head in here and try to line and match things up a bit properly. So let me just get this facing front a bit more. Like so. Maybe like this. No, let me take it down some more. I'm guessing maybe I should just tilt the edge downwards a bit more instead. Yes, let me do that instead. So I go to the lowest subdivision level. Max this out some more. Invert the max. Just get this down here instead. Let me do that. Let me make sure symmetry is turned off. Yeah, I think something like this should be fine. Turn on symmetry, then we just smooth all of this out. Let's get something facing us a bit more. Get this down. Just trying to match the put the eye in place again. Yeah, I think you should be fine. The body. So let's this minuscule is still here, so let's just get that also in place. So roughly there should be fine. So now let's go to, where is it, texture. Let's import a texture in here. Let's just use the imports around here. Let's bring in our image. So let's plug it into Spotlight. So select the image, then add to Spotlight. So let's start by scaling this down. Get this down somewhere around here should be fine. Now hit Z on the keyboard, then let's align. So the idea is to kind of make sure you kind of align the high. So make sure you align the eye to the eye of our reference also. So the eye will be like our anchor point for this. So I need to scale this up a bit more. So I'm not going to be completely obsessed with getting the perfect shape of the eye, at least for the both eye. I just need something close enough, kind of capture the eye around there. Okay. Let me scale this down some more. So I'm trying to kind of eyeball and kind of capture the size of the eye properly. This is like the most tricky part about the entire process. Trying to align the character's eye properly. Think we're close enough. Yes, I think somewhere around here looks almost fine. Oh, the neck feels like it should be wider or something. So I should scale that out. Maybe I'm trying to match the neck instead of the neck. I will completely lose a lot of the adjustment I've made. So the eye is like our main anchor points. I can just get this. Just get this right again. I think this should be roughly there. This looks roughly there. So let me first start by saving this camera setup. So under is it documents or under draw? Okay, let's so click on store camera. So let me just name this to front cam. Okay. So I've saved that camera in there now. So if we should kind of shift Z, go out of this, and just go back to draw and do this to snap to our camera view. That's precisely what we want. Let me just do a quick save. Okay, so we have that in there now. I think I would. Let's see if there's a way to kind of save out this camera. What does that do? Okay, I think it's already saved. So even if I close this file and open it again, it's already saved. So, but I would like to dock that camera on the side. So let's just keep it docked around here. So we can just quickly jump to it. Okay. So let's bring the image back up. So the move to so I'm seeing quite a lot of proportional changes we need to make in here. So take for example now the jaw. So the jaw needs to be a bit higher. Need a bit higher. I mean, sorry, we need to be a bit, we need to raise the jaw a bit higher. So let's say higher, or yes, let's say higher instead. Higher is the right word. So let's just get the jaw up a bit more, like so. If I'm doing this correctly, I want to make sure I'm doing this correctly. Okay. Let me show where that jaw is again. Okay, somewhere around there should be fine. The ears, let's see, I think I'll leave the ears where they are. They are fine where they are. So this I'll need to wait, I've knocked this out. Let me just get this right. Great. So I'm kind of focusing on just one on just one aspect of it. Let me smooth this down. I don't want it to be too much. So I'm being careful not to kind of exaggerate it too much. So now it feels a bit too exaggerated. So I'm going to smooth that down. Okay, something like this should be fine. Maybe that's way too much. Let's just get this back like so. So in this part, this is the part to kind of make sure we kind of capture the silhouette of the head properly before moving on. Trying to figure out where the nose is. Let me try to take this down some more. Think somewhere around here seems okay, something like this will be fine. But it almost feels that maybe I'm not doing anything, but I'm actually doing something in there. So now let's get the lips in place. So what I'm actually going to do is I'll go to the gizmo. Turn off symmetry for now. Then we'll do this. I'll hold control and then I'll just drag this out. Let me get a bit closer. Hold control and just drag this out. Let's see what we have. Yes, something like that. I'm trying to max out the kind of unmax the upper lip and just max out the lower lip. So something like this should be fine. So that's when I use the move brush. It's really affecting most of the upper lip. Maybe I should be more precise in here instead. You see, make it turned on. Let me do this again. Try to be more precise with this. I don't know if I'm capturing this properly. Maybe to be more precise, maybe I should use the Max Lasso. Then probably give this a separate poly group. Control W to give that a separate poly group. Nah, it's not working correctly. I can see I'm capturing some parts that I don't need. So let me just be more precise again with this. So I'm trying to deselect all of this. Oh, I did the opposite. So I want to be as precise as possible with this. So Control W for this. Let's make sure. Yeah, I think this is precise enough, so that should work just fine. Okay. So now, yeah, I can see that this guy has a fuller lip. The lip is quite full. He has a full lip to him. So we want to try as much as possible to kind of capture that. Let's go back to the camera. What is this? So let's max this out. Blur the max a bit more. Then snap this back to the camera view. Then shift Z to bring out the spotlights. Let's figure out where that lip is. Turn on symmetry. Symmetry turned on for this. Okay, turn on symmetry. Nah, this is not going to work. This is not going to work. We need to use a different approach for this. A better approach would be to, let's just go to one subdivision level higher. I'm going to use the standard brush with the low intensity, the low brush size. So I'm going to use that kind of figure out where probably increases a bit more. I'm going to use this kind of figure out where this lip should be. So let's do something like so. So now we know the lip should be somewhere around here. It is quite high. That is quite high. Let me undo that. I think I'm going to first of all use the move brush and move this up a bit higher where it should be. I'm going to be in these points. So these points, raise them up like so. Okay, something like this. The idea is that so as long as I have this raised up like so, then I can now kind of flesh this out even more. So invert the selection now. First of all, let's map out the edge of the lip. So now that's way too aggressive. So take this down. Let me undo that. And let me do that again. I didn't get that correctly. And the brush size is too big. Okay. It's somewhere around here, it should be fine. So the next we're going to do is to simply to make this lip a bit fuller. So I'm going to use the move brush. Let's get this guy some fuller lips. But this is like one of the major features of the guy's face, is a fuller lip. Let's invert the selection. I'm not sure I made the right decision making this lip part a bit open though. But I think we can make it work, so let's just although he has his lips a bit open. So I'm going to bring this down. Let me zoom out some more. I'm going to use a bigger brush size for the move. I just get something around here like so. Okay. Somewhere around here should be fine. Let me smooth this out a bit more. So now I believe I can get this out. Let's go one subdivision level higher. Snap to the main camera setup, and then I'm going to use the standard brush to kind of block out where, no, I'm not doing that properly. So let's see how much depth we have there. Okay, this is like the most important part of the process. We just need to get this right as much as we can. No, not correct. There's something exactly wrong with my brush. It's my pen tool. It's not giving us straight lines as it should. Maybe there's lazy mouse turned off here.